A subdomain takeover happens when a hacker gains access to a particular subdomain of a company or an organization. This can leave the organization vulnerable to multiple cyber attacks and other data breaches. In this video, I'm going to share how hackers actually do that, what's their MO, and how you can protect yourself by continuously scanning for the vulnerabilities on your company's domain. The technique I'm about to show you is one of many security findings hackers get paid for, and legally. Platforms like HackerOne, BugCrowd, and others will pay a lot of cash if you find a hackable subdomain on one of their bug bounty programs. Check out the video above to see another technique with which you can find secrets on public Git repos, which can pay even more. I'm going to start off by running AMAS and its subcommand enum. While I'm waiting for that, and I'm running it, by the way, against fiverr.com for an example, and teeing that into a file so we can actually see the result. If you don't know OWASP, which are the developers of AMAS, OWASP is the Open Worldwide Application Security Project. It's a non-profit foundation that works to improve the security of software all around the world, and a part of it is contributing to open source and managing projects like AMAS. As for AMAS itself, reading from their GitHub project file, it says that it's a project that performs network mapping of attack surfaces and external asset discovery using open source information gathering and active reconnaissance techniques. And what it means by that is that there are different APIs and sources that it's reading from all around the internet, and it can collect different types of data. This starts from certificates, where we're getting the data that you can see now on the screen, and it goes to DNS public entries, going through tools that can discover all kinds of registered addresses, IP info, PII data, big data cloud, CSP headers, etc., etc. It's super interesting, and I highly recommend you go check it out. I'm leaving the description down below. So we're getting all kinds of subdomains of Fiverr up to our screen. Probably most of it they don't want us to see, but it's public information and you can all get it with open source tooling like I do. I'm using tmux here, and by the way, you can check out my tmux video to see how I manipulate text in the screen like I do. I'm going to copy one of them. For an example, this is going to be the insider subdomain, and let's try xh to query the domain and see whether that's something that's even up. In a lot of times and a lot of cases, you can actually see different endpoints that are not valid and nothing that you can actually query. In this case, it exists, so I'm going to keep all that list of endpoints and going to check that in a mass manner. So I'm going to use HTTP probe, and that's a tool by TomNomNom on GitHub. I'll leave the description also below in the description. And that tool actually probes different endpoints for HTTP and HTTPS and checks whether that they're live or not. And if it's live, it keeps them in the list so we can query them later on, like I did manually with the insider endpoint. When HTTP probe is done, we can see the list and check out that we're happy with it. And once we are, we're going to use that for our next level. The next level is going to probe it with a tool that's called NTHIM. I'm going to show it now. NTHIM, funny enough, stands for Now the Host is Mine. And it's a super fast subdomain takeover detection, which basically scans for all of the subdomains that we found that were actually operational and checks them for different endpoints that they may point to that are able for takeover. So I'm running it with the verbose flag and adding the minus F to input a file, and you can see it's just starting to scroll through the endpoints and show us that most of them are obviously not vulnerable, but from time to time we can see stuff popping up like CloudFront or S3 buckets or stuff that are actually not meant to be there, and it is found as a possible subdomain takeover. If we scroll up the list, we can see what it actually found, and we can see one domain that's possible subdomain takeover pointing at CloudFront, but this is pretty much it. So Fiverr are kind of good in their security. We're going to check another domain. This domain is going to be Spot.im, what's today known as Open Web. I have a pre-scanned list of all of the subdomains that I found for them with the exact same tooling, so I'm not going to take you through the exact same scenario, but let's see what we can do with the HTTP probe results that I got for Spot.im. So I'm running NTHIM again, but this time again the Spot.im URLs. And let's see the results here. So we can see all kinds of interesting stuff. Uptime robot, CloudFront, some errors that couldn't have been probed, but that's pretty much it. For understandable reasons, I'm not going to take this a step forward and showing you how to actually make use of these, because these are public endpoints of public companies and I don't want to go to places that I shouldn't, but it's very easy to find the instructions on how to take action on this. What I want to show here is actually this tooling can be set up to protect you. If that scanned regularly, it doesn't even have to be every hour or every day, it's enough to scan once a week or once every time a DNS entry has changes deployed into it, you can probably keep yourself safe from subdomain takeover.